This is gonna stop happening eventually, I promise. So, the last episode I recorded, I was way too quiet. You could not hear me at all. So, instead of putting that out, I scrapped it. And here we are. Let's go over a quick overview of what I did in the lost episode. Talk to this guy. Beat the bosses. Rang the bell. Wee! Talk to this guy, not this jester. Parry, freed this guy, upgraded our Estus. Killed this guy, took his weapon, and killed a demon down here. And that is what we did last episode. Now, I don't have the strength required to wield this katana with one hand, so with these almost 6,000 souls, we need 12? 14? 14. I don't think I'll be able to get there. Ooh, almost. So let's just kill some hollows to get that. Shouldn't take too long. Probably these three and then the Balder Knight that's right over there. So from now on, I'm gonna do my best to speak as quickly as I possibly can while still maintaining some not scream qualities. Because I'm a very quiet person, and that doesn't really work for recording gameplay and commentating over it. So that said, I'll do my best to talk loudly. Hello. Goodbye. No draw. Alright. That should get me to 14. That'll allow me to use a shield while I use this sword. So, yeah. I'm still, still getting the hang of doing this. Don't quite have audio completely figured out. Hopefully this will sound better. I think I'm talking loudly. I feel like I'm talking loudly. I just walked right past the bonfire where I need to level up. Crap, was it 25? No. Awesome. There we go. Now I can go back to leveling dex, vitality, endurance, all those good stats. But in the meantime, we're gonna come down here into give me the bomb. No. Into Darkroot Garden. I was gonna wait for the game to go bwong and have the area name pop up, but apparently it doesn't want to do that. Oh, there we go, Darkroot Garden. And we're gonna fight a boss here. In the meantime, we'll just kill some tree men. There's one that pops up behind you. Not yet. Right here. Oh, and there's also one that's just out in the open. There we go. Don't. Okay. Was there another one that pops up? Not here. Right here. That's just a rock. That says magic. Alright. So, something I didn't know about when I first played this game. We come over here. Oh look, there's a bonfire. So what you do is you break this wall. And there you go. You got a bonfire. A nice checkpoint for this area. So you don't have to fight all those tree men every time you want to come down here. Right here is where we would use the Crest of Artorias from Andre that he sells for 20,000 souls. I don't have 20,000 souls, nor do I have that crest, so we'll leave that door. In here, I'm pretty sure that's just a soul item. And when you pick it up, you can see all these spiky bushes are tree men. When you pick it up, all these tree men pop up and ambush you. But that's not really worth it. So, wait. Isn't there one more tree man? Maybe I'm thinking of somewhere else. So let's pass through this fog. And what you want to do, once you pass through there, is you want to just hug this wall. Because there's a bunch of trees, and you see that guy laying down over there? He'll get up, and they're kind of tough to deal with. But if you hug this wall, you do not have to deal with any of that. There's a tree man that popped up. Bing. These guys drop moss clumps pretty much all the time. Here's a snake monster. I think there are only like two of these guys in the entire game, and they're both down here. Alright, keep hugging the wall. Just keep hugging. And here's the other snake man. And you get to this ruined building. Now in here, there is a stone man that you have to fight. He casts a spell that makes it so you can't run or dodge, apparently. Why was I not able to roll? Maybe it raises your equipment weight. So maybe from that I was over my max equip load. And when you're over your max equip load, you can't roll. So let's see if I can model that here. Darn. I don't quite have enough heavy stuff to be able to properly show that. But yeah, so if you are over your max equip weight or equip load, then you cannot roll. And I think that's what was going on there. So maybe, just in, if that's the case, let's put on a thief mask. That should be fine. Yeah, it's like, that's like an area of effect around that guy. Here's the tree that pops up. Oh, and someone just left a message about it. Try attacking. Yep. Let's see if I can kill this guy in 1R2. Hey. Yes, and they drop Egg Vermifuge, which comes in handy later if you do an optional thing. Alright, you can't attack them while they're getting up. Alright, can I roll? I cannot roll. So let's... Wow! Maybe I'll unequip... That's weird. I swear you're usually able to roll during that. Let's do that, just see if that helps me. I know I'm not really putting on a good show right now, but I swear you're usually able to roll while that effect's active. Maybe not, maybe you can run around him, and that's what I'm thinking about. Well, let's see. Can't run, can't roll. So that seems odd. I am like 100% certain you could roll, it would just be a fat roll. Might just have to run past that guy. And if I'm doing that, or here's a weird idea, maybe I'll try blocking his attacks. I don't know, just a thought. I'm gonna become human here. Because I expect to be fighting a boss. And it's an annoying boss with a very useful summon right before them that I will be using, because otherwise the fight takes, I don't know, 5 minutes, something. You basically have to wait for the boss to come into your attack range, and then you're able to attack it for a short time before you have to go through the whole thing again. So, let's try blocking this time. Alright, it's working out. Alright, the spell's effects have worn off. Alright. Oh, and I got his great shield. So that's the trick. You block his attacks, and circle to the right, until the effect wears off and then you kill him. Ghost ahead. Right here. We got the NPC, Witch Beatrice. Let's check out that great shield. I can't use it, it requires 38 strength. But it has really great resistances. Alright. Next. Alright, we got the witch. Let's go fight the boss. I don't think I had one of the cracked round shields. By the way, this boss? Right there. Right. Up there. It is 30, 30, 40, 30. Alright. I'm gonna be equipping the wooden shield then. Because this boss only attacks with magic. And I'll try to dodge the attacks, but it's not a sure thing that I'll be able to. Anytime, Witch Beatrice. Yeah! Go, hit him again. No, you're switching sides. Beatrice, anytime you want to attack, that's fine with me. Thank you. Alright, and here's where it comes into range of your attacks. Beatrice, you're better with magic. There it goes. When it starts doing that, you want to back off, or else what happened to Beatrice will happen to you. And now we play the waiting game again. We wait for it to come in, and we wait for Beatrice to cast her magic. There we go. One more Beatrice. One more Beatrice. There we go. Thank you, Beatrice. So yeah, that cuts down a super long, super tedious fight to just a couple minutes long. And it's not a hard fight either. You can dodge the attacks, you can heal when you get hit. It just takes a long time. Do my best to beat bosses by myself without any summon help. I don't think that should be a big ask for me. Not trying to brag or anything, I just don't think that should be a problem. 11,000 souls means I will level up. Yeah, so since there's no strength scaling on the Uchigatana, upping that doesn't up my weapon attack. But Dex does. But I don't like only getting 3 hits per stamina bar. So hopefully upping it to 100 stamina will fix that. And indeed it does. Now I can get 5. One more thing down here, and this will actually work for me since it wraps around. So when you get here, instead of going to the left, come to the right. There's this tree. with its roots wiggling about. Be wary of charging. I don't know if this tree can actually hit you, but if you just hit it enough times... it dies. And you can come through here. These weird toad mushrooms. Yeah. Let's keep going down. And there's another tree. Except you can slip past this one. I'm gonna just chop it up though. 270. 249, so it's actually better to do a bunch of one-handed attacks. Alright, that brings you to this little woody area. And in here, there are a few items. And again, this is another place with a one-off enemy, that being these weird frog mushrooms. Is that it? I think so. They drop green blossoms, which help with stamina regeneration. You get a nice soul item there. And if you come over this way, you got another stone man. Alright, so maybe you could never roll, and I was just misremembering that. But just circling them seems like it's good enough. It's pretty flexible for being made of stone. This is not the way. This is the way. I actually think if you don't get close to him and you just come up here, he'll come to life and ambush you while you're fighting. While you're fighting. This guy. Which is annoying. So just circle, circle, wait for them to do an attack. Circle, circle. He's backed up against a wall, so I can't really circle as well as I want to. They must do part magic damage because... oh no, never mind, I just still have the wooden shield equipped. There we go. And your reward for that shortcut... not shortcut, side area, is your very first ring, maybe, the wolf ring, which boosts your poise. And poise is basically your ability to get hit without getting staggered. So it's usually a pretty good... let's see if we can make this jump. Jump! another guy. I just don't want to get ambushed, so... Oh, and I missed that item. I think it's just a soul, yep. Useful nonetheless. I was trying to think of a Spoon Man parody using Stone Man. Something like, Stone Man, come together with your hands, slow me. I don't know, something like that. Because, you know, he puts his hands together and puts them up in the air when he slows you down. I don't know, there's something there. I'll leave it to the more talented people to actually have the rest of the lyrics. I don't think I want to do anything with Andre. I can't upgrade the Uchi Katana anymore. Got one more level. Health. Get a little more health, a little more survivability. So, if you remember the guy in the gold armor that I showed you while I was recapping what happened in the Lost episode, those in the know, I'm not going to kill him. I'm gonna let the... What are you doing? You should have your crossbow out. Parry! I'm not gonna kill him. I'm gonna let his side story play out. Parry! And right now, I am going to the next area of the game. The next area I need to go to progress. But first, backstab! Gimme. Nothing. Those guys have a very, very low chance to drop their weapon, which is a very, very good weapon. So I've heard. I've never actually been able to use it. And let's see. Yeah, this is the right way. Right now I'm running back to the Dragon Bridge, because that has the door that we need to go through to progress. You got me. Oh, there we go. Now, I think the dragon is going to swoop down. I'm pretty sure that's what's gonna happen here. Yeah, I think it's coming. Yep, there it is. Alright. What? How did you not kill those guys? There we go. So, I'm gonna get the dragon to leave again before I run the rest of the way back across this bridge. So, we wait and wait. There we go. I could try to kill it, but I don't think that's a good idea. I'm more likely to just die. Alright, there we go. Fly, you fool! Ooh, Titanite shard. And with that, we can come back this way. I'm pretty sure Solaire is gone. Oh no, he's still there. What's up, man? What are you doing?
Oh, hello there.
Okay, you're just gazing at the sun still. I tried to get him to help me during the Bell Gargoyle fight. That was the boss up on the roof. But I forgot to use the pine resin that I used during the Taurus Demon fight, because they are also weak to lightning. So I died pretty quickly that time. Second time through, I didn't summon him, and I beat him pretty handily because I actually remembered to equip the pine resin before the fight started. So, that, we come through here into Lower Undeadburg. Someone with no pants has a summon sign. And the first thing I'm gonna do is come up here and open this door. Hey, friends. And you may recognize this room from the two axe guys and the sword and shield guy. This is at the very beginning of the Undeadburg. So now I just have a nice easy shortcut to Lower Undeadburg. And I think that's where I'm going to leave this episode off. I hope you've enjoyed it. Again, sorry about losing that episode. As I said, I'm still trying to get into the swing of doing this, and I've learned my lesson to talk louder. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, hit like. If you like my commentary, or think my commentary is getting better, then consider hitting subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching.